I blow a bag today. I don't do nothing for gas. I blow the bag today. Walk in the mall and go crazy. I blow a bag today. I buy it up on the paper. I blow a bag today. I put a whip on the man. I blow a bag today. I blow a bag today.
This is 50.com. We out here exclusively. Yo, it's the Scum Lord. The Heineken is here.
DJ Thorough, a.k.a. Thorozano, the bridge to the streets. Let's go.
And it's the boy Punch, the new face, just looking like new money. I'm still happy to be here.
Yo, we got Miss Priscilla.
Hey.
Fresh off the reality show.
She's got game.
She's got game. Let's talk about it. You're about to sue Mr. Game for an undisclosed amount. Yes, yes.
Let's get to the meat and motherfucking potatoes.
So suing this. Are you going to get money from this motherfucker?
Yo.
He said, I will never pay anybody.
And I'm saying this to him. Oh. You are giving me $10 million.
Let's go. Who's going to give you $10 million?
Jaycion motherfucking Taylor.
Also known as?
The Game.
Let's go.
It's giving me $10 million.
And why is he going to give?
Never mind.
Why is he giving you $10 million?
This nigga's giving me $10 million because I'm probably the first female that ever stood up for his disrespectfulness.
To the mic.
How did he disrespect you for the people that are unaware? Because we got to build this case.
I think everybody else is already aware of what's going on because they probably hate me for it because I let everybody know that he sexually assaulted me. And this is real. And he also attacked me, and this is caught on camera. And let me say this right now. And I'm going to say it right now. But 51 Minds, if it ain't real, why y'all offer me money?
51 Minds, the production company behind these reality shows. Just had to clarify these things.
I got a question. Speaking on law terms, is it going to hinder you for talking about this?
Nope.
No? Okay, I'm just wondering.
Now, let's talk about this. Oh, as you're drinking quality.
That quality, yeah.
No, because, you know, his lawyers are going to watch these interviews.
Right.
And it doesn't matter. I've already talked to their lawyers. I've already talked to his lawyers. It doesn't matter. It doesn't change what happened. It doesn't matter because it doesn't change what happened. You still ain't recognize what you did. You still didn't acknowledge it. You still didn't apologize for what you did. You bashed me, made it look like you didn't pick me to go on the show, like I never met you prior to it, like we didn't sit down three times during filming, talked about how I'm just there for TV. I didn't like you either. Smokey the Bear looking ass nigga.
Damn, she jumped right in character.
So, what did he do? Did he whip his cock out and try to, like...
No.
Because, you know, niggas do that in a strip club.
He did not rape me.
No, I'm not saying he raped you, but
he didn't. Let's clear that up now. I'm not screaming rape. He did not rape me. He did not rape me. No. But what he did do is touch my pussy three times and told me shut the fuck up before I eliminate you, and then pulled my dress up in front of a crowd of people in Chicago at a club with the lights on and people taking pictures.
Yo, $10 million. Wow.
And then attacked me to the point that three cameramen walked off set and quit because they got daughters and wives at home and they said he's a piece of shit. Oh, you didn't know I got to see this footage, but I did. Get out my DMs.
Yo, Punch, backboard right now.
What do you got?
Listen. Tim Hardaway, right now.
So, look, I'm just at, yo.
Thank you, Priscilla, for your honesty and transparency on
my lace closure. Excuse me?
I don't know. I said transparency. I didn't say nothing about
that. That's what he said.
I hear she addressing. Look, just to play devil's advocate, because there's not much more room to go from that. What do you say to the people that's just like, yo, this girl just trying to come up off a rapper?
What do I say to the men? If I'm gonna start with the women. The women, if y'all can't stand up for another woman who's standing up for y'all rights, I discuss y'all. And then for y'all kids, y'all daughters, y'all nieces and y'all nephews, I'm doing this for them. I'm doing this for them. Because nobody ever has to sit back and take it from a man just because he has money. This man said, I'll choke the shit out you. And I said, then what? He said, I'll pay you. And this is on camera.
Are you reaching for the film?
I'm reaching for my DMs.
Oh, oh shit. Yo.
Is this an apology?
Oh, get this on camera.
Is that an apology?
This is 50.com. Get this on camera. Hold on. Let's bring this right here, Priscilla. You got the focus, nigga? Exclusive. Focus that shit properly, yo. Are we focused, nigga? All right, then. We swing.
And this came way after the show was filmed. Way after the show was filmed.
Now, Priscilla.
Game, and that's not the only one.
Game did an interview on The Breakfast Club where they spoke about his lawsuits. And he said, I swear to God.
Nobody has a clue the things that I've been through because of this incident. I went there because I wanted to be on TV. I owned the Mobile Day Spa. I had a clothing line, which I still do. Mm-hmm. And I did these things to excel myself.
Understood.
I never knew who I was going on the show for. I didn't know until I got touched down in L.A. Nobody knew.
Well, so VH1 just contacts you and say you're going to be on a show?
Casting director contacted me.
And then
you
want to
be on
a
show?
Game.
Yeah.
Oh, right. I asked. And then that's right. When you met him before everything?
I met him before even asked to be on the show. I met him at the studio in Miami chilling with friends last year around Halloween. He's sleeping with three of my homegirls. I know this. He FaceTimes them in front of me during the filming of the show. I grab the phone, talks to them. You didn't like me, I didn't like you either. We know that. We talked about that. This is to Jaycion.
Right. But let's get back to this, though. He said... In the interview, I swear to God, I will not pay any, I will spend all my money before I give him a dime, and I'll only collect physical cash.
Oh, he said he'll spend all of his money before he give me a dime because he's going to have to.
He said it's on record on the interview, Breakfast Club.
He's
going
to have
find
to.
This.
He's going to have to.
He said he'll go on tour and
you know
get physical
why?
Cash.
You know why?
To stop people.
Because you can't feel as if you can do whatever you want to do and then just cut somebody a check like you do your nanny.
Jesus.
You can't do that. Y'all bash me because I got a criminal record? This man got 27 open cases.
Yo, you from Philly for real.
North Philly. That's different. Jesus. Get it right. North Philly. It's a difference.
I done been through a lot because of this.
Let me ask you a question. This is a serious offense. I'm assuming it's you and your lawyers. How did y'all come up with the figure $10 million? Why not $20 million?
I'ma say this. I'ma say this, okay? And I hope my lawyers hear this. Mm-hmm. That, and they will. I think that was pretty shady, honestly. They said they came up with the figure because they wanted to make sure he could never just hurt somebody and cut a check. That's understandable. But I myself was like, damn, 10 mil? I found out through social media like everybody else.
Mm. Oh, okay.
I asked my lawyers how much. They said, oh, a couple mil. We going to fuck him up. He ain't never going to do this to nobody again. I was like, all right, cool. I didn't care. I didn't care about the money, nigga. Just acknowledge what you did. Apologize for what the fuck you did.
Right.
Apologize and don't do that shit again. Every woman don't like you just because of who you are.
So out of what you're saying, maybe I'm hearing wrong. If you felt like Game apologized to you, you wouldn't have took it legally.
But I actually waited for 2 days when we were not filming. And when I was around him for all of maybe 2 hours... it got ugly. This nigga, I brung it up on camera because I wanted an apology. This man said, fuck you, you live in my world. This man said, I will choke the shit out of you and pay you. There will be no apology.
I don't know how to follow up with this. Other than once you collect this lawsuit or however you punish, well... you get your retribution. What's the next move for Priscilla?
You know, a case like this can be fought for years. So the next move for Priscilla is happening now.
Your own reality show? This is in the works. And then, you know,
right now,
Oxygen, Oprah, OWN. I mean, Oxygen, OWN.
I kind of like VH1 because they let me be me. Listen, I gave them good TV.
Who are you?
Who
are you?
This is me.
If you had to describe yourself, who are you?
I'm a person who gives too much.
You got a
and
nice
then,
shape, too.
Thank you. Thank you.
My fault.
I'm a person who gives too much. I give to the point that when you hurt me, it hurts deep. So when I blow up on a person, I blow up. It's just as simple, but it takes a lot to get me to that point. I'm a very hardworking woman. Yes, I've been to college. Yes, I have always worked, held down multiple jobs at one time, every time, take care of my whole family, and I got 10 siblings, 10, and all of them have children. And I help all of my family. Mm. I'm just, look, I'm just
I mean, I'm giving it a stage, you know what I mean? She's talking with the Khaled voice, you know what I mean? 10 jobs. I'm with you.
100 grand.
You know what I mean? She got the theatric cinematic tone.
You ever done any, like, crazy jobs?
Because you know what? Because
you got the body to be, a, like, you know.
You know, I've been bartender at, I bartended at a strip club before.
You have a strip club?
No. I bartended at a strip club before.
What do you think about bartenders and strip clubs now? Because they got them cool. Wearing less and less and less.
I don't think so. I think they got them wearing, like, synchronized uniforms that change every day type of thing. They got them on some, like, showstopper type stuff. Y'all ain't hear it's a new show coming out called Strippers in Miami. They making these girls famous. Wow.
And what are they doing on this show?
I don't even know. I think they're stripping.
If they're not catching the cack, I don't care, yo.
Listen, I fucks with it, though. I love these females. A lot of my friends are in that industry. A lot of my friends are psychologists. A lot of my friends are other types of business owners. But at the same time, I fuck every walk in this world. If you vibe with me, I fucks with you. I get along with you. Even if I don't vibe with you immediately, I get over it quick. And I'll vibe with you like 5 minutes later. That's why they wanted to say they were scared of me on the show. Because I probably wanted to fight them and then be their friend. And then fight them again and be their friend. And fight them again and be their friend.
She's from Philly for
like
real.
North Philly.
She's from Philly for real. North Philly. You stabbed me like I was ARF, yo. Yo, Priscilla, live on thisis50.com.
Wow.
You know, she just let us know her story.
You made a lot of statements today, man.
Yo,
Tom,
a lot of statements. I hope I did.
You rep like you Moses Malone. R.I.P. Moses Malone, my nigga.
Because I held this in while the world bashed me for how many months now?
How long?
Four or five months?
Yeah, give a
shit. I have been called names that I couldn't even think of on my own. People have said things to me that myself, I would never think to say that to somebody.
Yeah.
These people have tried to tear me down.
Well, you still with these standing. Fancy nails standing. Right here, you know. Hold on, you got small hands.
She's a female.
You know, you know what Mickey Mantle said about.
She's a ninja. Like she's doing a bunch of shit.
You know what Mickey Mantle said about a woman with small hands?
What they say?
Make everything look bigger in life.
You better be careful. Yeah. You have a lawsuit too.
I blow a bag today. I don't do nothing for gas. I blow the bag today. Walking the mall and go crazy. I blow a bag.